Mr. Beagley.
Hey there, guys and gals, it's Gerbeagly with another episode of Gaming with Gerbeagly, and I'm once again playing the game Dream Daddy, and I'm very excited to be back, guys. As you guys already know, I absolutely love the characters in this game. I love the writing. I think all of it's really quirky and fun and very lighthearted, and it's just like a goofy, heartfelt game. I like that. I like a game that gives me like those warm feels when I play it. But anyway, so last episode, we finished our Pokemon battle with Brian. We also ended up meeting another dad named Matt, who owns the coffee shop. He was really cool. There's another dad sitting in there, sort of like brooding and staring at us, but we didn't get to meet him. And then finally, we met the dad, Joseph, who is like sort of like the Stepford Wives style, very posh dad. And he has like 4 kids or something like that, some crazy amount of kids. And he gave us some cookies that apparently weren't very good, but we're on our way now to return them to his house. So let's dive in. Let's see if we can find out where he lives and hopefully return his cookie plate. Shoot, I'm actually not sure which house is his.
I'd hazard a guess it's the big one with all of the well-groomed blonde children sitting in the yard.
Oh, Amanda, you smart aleck. Good eye, kid.
And remember, we need to make a positive first impression here. Keep it light.
We walk up to the kids and wave. Aw. Oh, wow. We see all of them. Well, 3 of them. Good lord, they certainly are definitely Joseph's kids. Hey, guys, is your dad around? They all just stare at us blankly. We just wanted to... return this nice plate, and thank you for the cookies. Jeez, these definitely are Joseph's kids. They all look exactly like him. Oh, okay. They were really good? None of them are talking? Okay. I mean, I heard they were good. I didn't get to eat any. I chuckle nervously.
Well, okay, we're just gonna set this plate down on the ground real gentle and then back away slowly. Right, Dad?
Right. That's what we're gonna do. The kids' eyes bore into us as we scurry away. I can feel their gaze on my back even as we approach our house.
I need something to get my mind off of those carbon copy kids.
I need to rest my... Oh, that's right. Okay, so I had one more choice to do before I had picked all 3 or 4 of the original choices. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to say, I need to rest my eyes. I need a nap. Dad needs a nap in his recliner.
You've been awake for what? 3 hours?
And that's 3 hours too many. That's the way that I live as well. Actually, like, I live off of naps. I get a lot of shit over on Twitter because people will be like, why are you awake right now? Why aren't you in bed? It's late. And I'm like, I don't need to sleep for like a full 8 hours all the time. I do it a ton, but I run off of a lot of naps, guys. And it's fine. I've done plenty of reading and research. I've been around for a while. I get it. I'm okay. I'm safe. No need to worry about me. No need to mom the dad, okay? As we're walking home, I hear heavy footsteps coming up behind us. Grouper, bro.
Hey.
I turn around and I'm greeted by a familiar face jogging up to us. Oh, hello, another dad. Wow, look at him. He's got like a part of his eyebrow shaved out and he's got a baby. He's got a little baby and he's got like an iPhone in his arm. Look at him. He's a tall, dark, handsome man. Craig?
Oh.
Bro. Bro. Oh. Holy, wow. I haven't seen Craig in forever. It's been too long, dude. Yeah, wow, you look great.
Hey.
Yeah, I cleaned up my act. Cleaned up his act? Are you kidding me? He's ripped. Amanda, this is my friend Craig. We went to college together. We were roommates for a while, too. Amanda, dude, you probably don't remember me, but you're so big now.
Hello, and hello, cute baby.
Yeah, thank you. The last time I saw you, I think you were about her size. This is River. Say hi, River. He picks up her tiny wrist and waves it around. River gurgles happily. Aw, how cute. Are you babysitting?
Oh.
Nah, dude. River's my kid. Man, it has been a long time. Feels like 1 minute we're rolling up to exams with bad hangovers, and the next we're both fathers. Where you been, man?
Nice.
Yeah, I was working out in California and just relocated the business back to Maple Bay. No kidding. A man and I just moved to this side of town. How's Smashley doing?
Oh, man.
I mean, Ashley. Ashley is her name.
Oh.
She actually still goes by Smashley, and we got divorced last year. Oh, dude, I'm so sorry.
Oh.
Bringing up a sore subject here. It's old news. We take turns taking care of River and the twins. It's all copacetic. Oh, they got twins too. Holy crap. twins? You have three kids? Ain't life something, bro? Remember? Right? Why did I say remember? I think I was thinking of like, remember that time we did that crazy thing? Kegstand Craig is a father of three. Oh, there we go. You know what? Here's a quick side story, guys. I was actually in a fraternity when I was in college, and there were a lot of keg stands and a lot of beer pong tournaments and a lot of really stupid fucking shit that went down. So I totally relate to Craig. You know what? I think that I've cleaned up my act for the most part. I hope. I'm a YouTuber now, so I guess that's cleaning it up. Anyway, let's move on.
Keg Stand Craig?
Oh. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it was my old college nickname. He got it because he did a lot of keg stands. It's that thing where you do a handstand on a keg and then drink from the keg.
Right.
He was very good at it. Yeah, bro, I hate to be that guy, but I'm in the middle of my daily jog and I really gotta keep up my heart rate. Brought River along for, you know, resistance training. You jog daily? I jog yearly. On January 1st, when I promise myself that I'm gonna jog daily for the rest of the year, but give up after 30 minutes and just walk home. Well, it's never too late to get back into it, dude. You should join me sometime. I don't know. Come on, it'd be fun. We could grab breakfast afterwards, catch up. We could do a bro brunch like the good old days. There we go, bro brunch. All right, sure. Sounds great. Great, let's get that going soon. I better get moving. Good to see you guys. Craig gives a little wave, puts his earbuds back in, and jogs off. I can't believe Craig is ripped and has kids. I'm reeling.
Why is that?
The Craig I knew is not fit to be responsible for any living thing, including and especially himself. One time, I watched him drink an entire jar of marinara sauce for dinner. Amanda, he opened up a new jar of marinara sauce, and then he drank it like it was a thing that normal people do. It was unholy. And then I asked him what the hell he was doing, and he said, and I quote, "It's basically a smoothie, bro."
I mean, technically, he's not wrong.
He jogs. He was jogging. He's like a totally different person. Anyway, we better get home. I'll have plenty of time to reflect on how old I feel later. Ah, Grouper McDangistu, living out his memories. Amanda and I flop down onto the couch. Amanda has to shove some empty boxes out of the way before she can sit.
Too bad we're gonna be putting my stuff right back into these boxes in a few months.
No, don't say that.
Aw, Dad, it's gonna be okay. I'll be fine.
I know. Oh, she's going off to college. It's just, you're my little girl. It's gonna be weird not having you around.
I'll come visit, and I'll text you every day, and I'll take lots of pictures. I mean, obviously, I'm a photography major.
You promise? Oh.
Of course. Are you gonna be okay with or by your lonesome?
Oh, come on. I'll be fine. I'll get a dog or something.
A dog? Forget art school. I'll stay for the dog.
Is that what it's gonna take?
Medium-sized dog. Handkerchief around the neck. I get to name it. That's what it'll cost for me to give up on my dreams. I am a woman of simple wants and needs.
Well, a dog is a lot cheaper than college. Amanda laughs. Suddenly, a pile of envelopes slides through the mail slot. Speaking of college... Amanda darts over to the envelopes and shuffles through them. She pulls one out and throws the rest back on the floor.
This is from McGowan College of Art and Design.
Open it.
But I'm scared.
It's just an envelope.
Yeah, it's just like my entire future. Not a big deal.
She takes a deep breath and rips the letter open with her teeth. Oh, I remember that, getting those college acceptance letters and being really freaking nervous about it. We have a letter opener, but okay. I hold my breath while Amanda's eyes dart back and forth, scanning the letter. What does it say?
The admissions committee has reviewed your application, blah, blah, blah. Her
face drops.
Regret to inform you that we were unable to offer you admission to McGowan College of Art and Design.
Oh no, poor Amanda. I'm sorry to hear that, sweetie pie. Amanda throws the letter on the coffee table. Oh, sweetie. Aww.
It's okay. I kind of saw it coming. I knew I shouldn't have put that experimental stuff in my portfolio. Their admissions officer told me they just want to see portraits or whatever.
I pull Amanda in for a big hug. That's boring, though, Amanda. I'm glad that you were yourself and you tried to take a risk there. That's how you get ahead in life. You're an amazing photographer. I know how much work you put into your portfolio. Some other school is going to want to snatch you up for sure. Mm.
Yeah, I know. It's fine.
Are you actually fine, or are you just saying that?
I'm fine, really.
Her face says the opposite, but I probably shouldn't push her on this.
Oh, and before I forget, Emma R and Emma P are sleeping over tonight. So...
You need me out of the way because I'm painfully uncool?
I would choose more delicate phrasing, but yes.
Well, I'll have you know that I conveniently already have plans for tonight, so you'll have the new place to yourself.
Yeah? What are your plans?
Quick, think of plans. I'm secretly the mayor of this town. Gotta attend the union meeting or I'm going clubbing. Oh shit, fam. We are totally going clubbing. That's what's happening. I'm gonna put on a nice outfit and go tear it up on the dance floor. All the hottest dance moves. The lawnmower, the sprinkler, the running man. You know, the ones all the kids these days are doing.
All right, but I'm not gonna come pick you up if you pull anything this time. Not again.
I'm just kidding. I'm actually going to... Oh. Go to bed or go out and watch the game. Oh, we are going out to watch the game, guys. Nice.
Which game?
You know, the game. The one that's on tonight. Dad. The game on TV. At somewhere other than here.
Okay, cool. While you do that, I'm gonna go do drugs and commit some light arson with the Emmas.
I'm concerned you're hanging out with the wrong crowd. Amanda shrugs. I would have expected you guys to be up to white-collar crime by this point. Maybe money laundering at the least.
I'm a street rat, Pops.
You're kidding about doing drugs and crime, right?
Yes, Dad.
Just making sure. I give her a pat on the head.
Have fun with your sports.
Are you being sarcastic?
No, making fun of sports is played out.
All right, then. I do some light cleaning around the house and decide to clear out right before Amanda's friends arrive. Before I leave, Amanda stops me.
Hey, don't forget that you have that meeting with my English teacher tomorrow.
Oh, right, Mr. Vega. Yep, totally remembered. I'll be there. Oh, sounds like I probably didn't remember, and it was a good reminder. It's a good thing. This is why you have kids, guys, is to be your reminder. Wow, I guess I really didn't think this plan through. I'm not entirely sure where the closest bar is, and Amanda still hasn't shown me how to use the GPS on my phone, so I'm just gonna pick a direction and walk in it. Let's go this way. Cool. Okay, we're marching. We're marching in the direction of the game. Any game, really. In the distance. Could it be... The sounds of the game. Oh, Jim and Kim's bar. Nice. A big burned out neon sign hangs above a tiny dive bar. Jim and Kim's, huh? All right. It'll do. I bet we're gonna meet some more daddies here, guys. I'm excited. The bar is small and dimly lit. The crack of pool balls sounds in the back as patrons laugh and joke. A string of multicolored Christmas lights hover above the bartender. I can't tell if he's Jim or Kim. I pull up a seat at the bar. What'll it be? One beer, please. Sure thing, boss. The bartender slides me an ice-cold beer. I take it. Why is beer capitalized? I guess it's just the brand name beer. Beer brand beer. I take a sip and enjoy the refreshing taste. Say, are you Jim or Kim? I'm Neil. Oh. I awkwardly turn my attention to the game, which is playing on one of the TVs on the wall. As luck would have it, my team of preference is not only playing, but is currently in the lead, which is always a good thing. The brightly colored mascot, which is some kind of animal, does cartwheels. I love that this is just like this really vague, generic description of a sports team. It's the best. I silently cheer on my favorite team, hoping that I don't get into any confrontational arguments with a fan of the opposing team. Several people in this bar are wearing the distinctive colors of the team I dislike, although I believe from their demeanor that, like me, the passion for their team is all in good fun. A middle-aged, wow, hi there, lady. A middle-aged woman holding a nearly empty wine glass sidles up to the bar and sits uncomfortably close to me. She couldn't resist that McDangus Dew stench that I have going. I mean, it's not a stench. I'm not smelly, okay? Just like I established last episode, I'm not smelly. It's a good odor. It's pheromones, okay? That's what it is.
Hey, Sailor.
Oh, hello. Oh, her name's Mary.
Good to see fresh meat in here. I'm Mary. Come here often?
No, I actually just moved to this part of town today. I'm Grouper, by the way.
Are you watching the game?
Yeah, my preferred team is in the lead. If they keep this up, they'll win the game with ease.
Oh, I love that team. And also, I love that game. I love someone who knows their way around
balls. Oh, God. I'm getting the impression that she's a little drunk.
Buy a gal a drink.
Buy Mary a drink, or don't buy Mary a drink.
I mean, I'm not really digging you, Mary. You're a little bit aggressive for my tastes. But at the same time, like, maybe I should buy her a drink. I just noticed also she has this cross on. Maybe she's here picking up men because her and Joseph are just in, like, a relationship for show because, like, they're the picture-perfect family and they're not actually in love or something like that. Maybe she's with Joseph. That's my guess. That's my guess, is that she's Joseph's wife. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to say, don't buy Mary a drink. Because wasn't he like a pastor or something too? That would make a lot of sense. Anyway, a lot of people wear crosses. I could be completely wrong. Don't buy Mary a drink. I'm sorry. I'm just not into the super aggressive woman. Maybe some other time.
Sue yourself, Seller.
Mary saunters off, setting her sights on the newest bar patron to enter. Good Lord, Mary. I happily watch the game over another beer. The game has gotten close in terms of points, a little too close than what I'm comfortable with. After a particularly skilled player scores a number of points for the other team, putting them in the lead, I hear an affirmative grunt from another man at the bar. Go team. It's the brooding man. Oh, it's the brooding man from the coffee shop, guys. He sits alone, sipping whiskey, also capitalized, and watching the game as well. Enjoying the game? I am now that we're winning. Oh, we must be rooting for different teams. In my opinion, my team is far superior. I have to disagree with that. Based upon our win-loss record, I'd say that my team is superior. This is every sports argument ever. That's where you're wrong, since as it stands right now, my team is beating yours. The conversation ends there, and we both go back to silently rooting for our respective teams. The game is close, with both sides playing their hardest to win. But in the end, my team prevails. Quiet cheers ripple throughout the bar. I raise a respectful glass at the man drinking whiskey. He raises his in response. An unspoken truce is formed between us based on mutual love for the game. He motions to the bartender, who pours two glasses of whiskey. The man slides one over to me. The name's Robert. Thanks, I'm Grouper. You must be new here. Mary already hit on you? Yeah. Robert chuckles. She's a peach. Well, you picked the best bar in town. As slimy as it is, you'll never find a better spot than Jim and Kim's. That's not really a good sell, as slimy as it is. Is there actually a Jim or Kim that runs this place? No, that'd be Neil. Neil waves from across the bar. Good guy, Neil. Not enough Neils in this world. Oh, okay. You a whiskey fella or a beer fella? Beer, but I'll drink most things. You like shots? I like shots. I love shots. Ooh, shots fired. I don't like them. All right, I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to say I love shots. I'm going to get drunk with this daddy, and we're going to see what happens from here, guys. So I love me some shots. Thank God. Robert nods to Neil, who serves up two shots of whiskey. He hands one to me. Here's to your health. We take the shots. The whiskey burns going down, but I try my hardest to look tough. Wait, I think this is what making friends is. Okay, Grouper, this guy's out of my friend league, but I think if I play my cards right, we'll be pals in no time. Hell yeah. Compliment his hand tattoo, compliment his rugged good looks, or compliment his cool leather jacket. I don't know why I read those from bottom to top, but that's the way that I did it. So I'm gonna go cool leather jacket. Who doesn't like a good cool leather jacket? I don't want to compliment his rugged good looks because I feel like that's too forward for like a first meeting. Even though our ultimate goal is to get with all the daddies, I don't want to be that super aggressive dad. I don't want to be the dad that everyone's like, that guy, well, he'll sleep with any dad. So I'm gonna go with compliment his cool leather jacket. Hand tattoo, you know, some people get weird about tattoos. It could be like a bad keepsake of his. So, cool leather jacket. I like your jacket. Thanks. Been in my family a long time. Passed down from firstborn to firstborn. Cursed, some would say. Wow. Man, this guy's mysterious and cool. Way cooler than I am, at least. Robert signals to the bartender for another round. What are you doing here tonight? My daughter kicked me out of the house, running from my problems or trying to make friends. Oh man, I need a cool backstory too. I'm gonna say running from my problems. And then if he's like, oh, well, you gotta face your problems head on. Maybe we'll have like a bro bond over that, a daddy bond. The usual. I like your style. He gets up. Be right back, gotta powder my nose. Oh man, cocaine, or are you actually just like going poop or something? Never seen Neil this talkative. He must like you. Ha, I guess so. I gotta admit that Robert has a gruff charm to him. If a guy like that thinks I'm cool, then I really must be. Robert comes back from the bathroom and grabs his leather jacket. I'm gonna go home. You heading my way? Whoa. Right off the bat? Okay, Robert's the aggressor in this one. Good lord. Robert and I leave the bar and find ourselves walking in the same direction. I live in this cul-de-sac down the way. Does everybody live here? Me too. We just finished unpacking today. Hey. Great place to be. Good neighbors. Well, some of them. Who's that? We get to Robert's house, which is just a few houses away from mine. We stop and he turns to me. I don't kiss and tell, Rupert. So, are we doing this or what? Oh, what? You know, do you want to come inside or not? Whoa, damn, right? Seriously, holy crap, that was so quick. Good lord. I mean, the ultimate goal is to get with all the dads, so this is like an easy one, I guess. A wave of realization rushes over me. I blush. Lay it on smooth. Smile and nod or no thank you. Oh man, we're gonna be that smooth talking dad that all the other dads are talking about because he's so smooth when he lays it on. Well, I don't see why not. That sounded smoother in my head. Let's do it. Oh man. I follow him up to his door. He fumbles with his keys for a second and unlocks the door, leading me inside. The moment the door closes behind us, he pushes me up against the wall and kisses me, grabbing my hips. Oh man, we did, guys, we stumbled into it now. This is where it gets real. This is where the dad on dad action starts. I didn't think it was gonna happen already. Come on. Robert takes my hand and leads me up the stairs and into what I assume is his bedroom, but it's so dark that I can't see anything but Robert's intense expression. He kisses me again and I can hear him shucking off his jacket. I clumsily take off mine too. His hands roam down my chest and suddenly he's tugging at my belt. I don't normally do this. Do you want to stop? Yes or no? You know what? Guys, we're committed. We're committed to this already. We're gonna get down with the dad this episode. It's happening. We're gonna say no. No. Good. Robert continues to unbuckle my belt and guides me to the bed. Let's have some fun. Oh man. Robert, you dirty dog. Sunlight streams in between the slats of the blinds. My head is pounding. I really overdid it last night. Wait a minute. This isn't my old house or my new house. We were really inebriated, I guess. Oh, right. I look around for Robert, but find myself alone. Ah, man, he's just a rolling stone, that Robert. He does him and he leaves him. Good lord. Hello? There's a clatter from the bathroom, and the door opens. Oh, okay, so he's still there. That's good. Robert is fully dressed and grabs his keys. That was fun. Yeah, it was. You should go. Oh man, Robert, you're gonna do me like that, man? Come on, dude, we could have had something here. There's more of a connection. That's certainly not what I was expecting. Well, talk to you later. Robert cracks a smile. Sure, your clothes are over there. I hastily get dressed and show myself out. The sun is unbearably bright. I need to lie down. I start to make my way back home when I suddenly remember Amanda. Oh man, you know what? She's a big girl now. She can take care of herself. I'm sure she's fine. I rush back home and throw the door open. Something smells delicious. Amanda? Aww. Amanda runs out of the kitchen and looks slightly disappointed.
Oh man, I was kind of hoping you had gotten kidnapped and I was gonna have to come rescue you.
What a great daughter. I love her. Excuse me, guys. I got the burpees here. No, I made a friend at the bar last night and ended up sleeping over at his place. Where are the Emmas?
They left a little while ago.
Oh, you guys have fun?
Yeah, watched some movies, ate snacks, stole a car, you know, usual sleepover stuff.
You teens and your larceny. So, this breakfast that's cooking, what's that all about?
Well, there's hash browns and eggs and bacon.
Ooh, can I?
Yes, you can have some breakfast.
Bless you, sweet child. My head throbs. Ugh, I gotta do something about this hangover. Amanda, your loving father might have overdone it last night.
Oh, somebody's hungover.
Father of the Year, you wouldn't happen to have any aspirin or...
All right. I've got just the thing. Hang on.
Oh man, Amanda's secret hangover recipe. Amanda runs to the fridge and pulls out a jar of pickles. Oh, okay. Amanda, what?
Drink this.
The pickle juice?
Yep, it's what I used once, would assume someone would use. I would also assume that it works pretty well.
Oh, Amanda, you little underage drinker, you. How dare you? I raised you better than that. I mean, I'm sure she's responsible. I'm sure she's smart about it. She's my daughter, after all. I taught her better.
Although, I've never tried it before and won't do it, obviously.
Who raised you? Amanda Ann. Oh, her middle name's Ann. That's adorable. Or give her a stern yet resigned side eye. I'm gonna say, who raised you?
You did?
Right. Do as I say, not as I do.
You got it.
This better work. I down a sip of the tart juice.
No, more than that, way more than that. I mean, I assume.
Watch it, you. I drink more pickle juice and help myself to the delicious breakfast that Amanda has graciously allowed me to partake in. After inhaling some hash browns and dunking several pieces of bacon into runny egg yolk, I'm starting to feel a little better. Oh man, that sounds delicious. I want that breakfast food now. Amanda grabs her backpack and keys.
Well, I gotta get to class. Don't forget the meeting with Mr. Vega, okay? He said it was important. Love ya.
Aw, see ya later. I'll be there. Knock him dead, kiddo.
Always do.
She's so sassy, I love it. We do our secret handshake. Oh, they have a secret handshake. And she's off. I get a little work done at home before I glance at my watch and see that it's almost time for the meeting. I hop in the shower, change clothes, and head on my way. Still a little hungover. All right, awesome. So now we're at Amanda's school, guys, and we're here to meet one of the teachers, which I'm assuming is going to be another daddy, but we're going to save that for the next episode, guys. We got a lot done. We got a lot done this episode. But anyway, guys, I hope that you enjoyed this episode of Dream Daddy. I had a lot of fun reading it for you. I hope that you liked watching it. If you did, please be sure to hit the like button, share the video and favorite it. Also, be sure to subscribe to me if you guys haven't already. For those of you who have, thank you so much for all of your support. You guys are the best in the world. I love every single one of you. And as always, it was great seeing ya. Bye-bye. Sir Beagley.